Hello, horse racing enthusiasts. This is John. I'm calling. I'm videoing it in the night before I head off to Saratoga. So tomorrow is Wednesday, the 24th, and I'm going to be up at Saratoga for the races, Travers weekend. So, in my excitement, I've handicapped the first 2 days. I'm ready to talk to you a little bit today about tomorrow's card, but I just wanted to reiterate. What a card we have on Saturday. We're going to be up there live. We're going to be hitting the workouts in the morning. I'm going to be sending some videos and getting some, I'm thinking of a couple of interesting things too. Maybe some interviews with some of the horse players that I know up there. And I want to bring some good content this weekend. It's an exciting card on Saturday, culminating in the Travers. But there's some great horses. There's some great horses running. Lutruska's running. Jackie's Warrior's running again. We got Epicenter running. I mean, there's just a spectacular day for to see the best of the best. So I'm really excited by it on Saturday. So anyhow, let's get to it. Tomorrow's card is the 24th up at Saratoga. 10 race card. First rate is hurdles. I don't handicap the hurdles. If I play him, it's all luck anyhow, from my standpoint. I don't think my handicapping's going to really... I don't know what makes a good hurdle or what doesn't. I guess getting over the jump, but other than that, I don't really know anything about him. So, at any rate, we'll start with... I'm going to handicap three races. I handicapped the whole card, but I have three races that I think are interesting. So, let's get to it. Race two at Saratoga. It's a maiden special weight for fillies. You know, it's a restricted race for fillies, right? And New York breds. I took a quick look at this, and I found something that was interesting. A lot of first-timers, when you look at first-timers, you look at trainer percentages, you look at pedigrees, and then you look at workouts, and then you look where the jock lands. Where the jock lands means something, because they're going through this same analysis. They want to make money, so they want to get on the right horse, right? So, you know, the best jock up there, the best record this year is IRAD. Oh, before I get into that, so horses that have run already, we've already talked about this, running for the first time is a shock to the horse's system. It's the excitement, the crowd, the dirt in your face. Sometimes they feel the whip, right? The first time, really. And all these things, the bell, the gates opening, it's just like it's a whole thing all at once. They learn a lot that first race. So by definition, the horses that have run before, there's a couple of them in this race, have a little advantage, all other things being equal, to the rest of the horses. So when I look at these sort of two-year-old baby races, I'm looking at Tom's figures, I'm looking at who's run. And when I go and look at who's run, I see IRAD ran on the three, Gambling Girl, the last time out. Had a 56, came in, you know, looked like it progressed pretty well. Not great, but progressed pretty well. Todd Pletcher's the trainer, so we think second time out, this horse is gonna hit it, right? All right, so then we keep going down. There's another, Rosie's Diamond, number four. You know, didn't really show much. I'm going to wait on that one. Maddie's Grace, number five, showed initial gate speed. So this one is one to watch. Sire by Heart, Heartspun. Rudy Rodriguez is the trainer. Good trainer, having a tough meet, but a good trainer. And then we notice something. We notice IRAD's on that horse last time out. But today, or tomorrow, Manny Franco's riding. So what does that tell us? Well, what it tells me is IRAD wants to make money. IRAD wants to be on the best horse. I believe he had a choice which horse he's going to be on. And he made the choice. He's a pretty good expert, I would say, to go on the three. So that's my pick. And I'm really walking the plank with that one, huh? But, I mean, it's the chalk. It's going to go off, looks like one-to-one, probably be under that. By dialed in, IRAD's the best jockey. I'm sorry, but sometimes you have to take the chalk, right, and take the one-for-one. So I'm saying the three in the second race for my first pick. Second pick is the fifth race. The fifth race is... all right, the fifth race is a one-mile race. It's coming out of the new chute that they started this year. Very interesting in the new shoot. I believe that you have to have speed to get so you can make that first turn. When I take a look at this, I feel like there's a lot of speed in this race. Let's take the one out for a second. We'll look at the two, the 1A. 1A, you know, it runs can run either way, can run with speed, can run as a close. The two, Airshow, you know, has shown some speed. I just look at the early pace figures, and there's a lot of early pace in this race. You have Rosario on a pace, a fast horse. You have the five, you have Roderick, right? Whom I have picked first in my handicapping, because I just think the speed advantage is something. And it's going to be hard to sort of get around that. But right on the other side of him is another speed horse, right? So you have Kinetic Sky, the six, is a speed horse. So I feel like the way that this race is going to come out is the five is going to go to the top. The six is going to pressure him. And here's a long shot bet for you. I say go across the board, not heavy, a couple of bucks on the two. The two's a closer. You're going to see him. You're going to see him. It's called the Airshow, right? You're going to see him close into it. He's run pretty well at Saratoga. I think that has a good shot of coming in and placing. So if we have a speed breakdown, I'm going with the two in the fifth race. Last race, my last pick race and my last race of the day. It's similar strategies, and you guys will start to get the gist on this stuff. But the 10th race is an allowance race, 50,000, 1 mile on the turf. Last race at Saratoga, and it doesn't matter the day, you always have to find out where IRAD is. All right, that's probably the first thing that you do, is you check on where IRAD is. And IRAD is on the 8. The 8 ran a good speed figure. He's a 100. Kitten's Joy, I love Kitten's Joy, particularly on the turf, obviously. IRAD rode him once before to win. They brought him back. He gets back on. Chad Brown, there's nothing wrong with that horse, right? That's a good horse. I feel like we have another horse out here that is something special. The three, Miss Delicious. And this is my long shot pick for the day. California Chrome sired horse, run at Saratoga twice. That did not place, but seems to be progressing. His running lines look interesting. It looks like he's going to be there. Philly, I should say. She's a Philly. Looks like she'd be there. But the one big thing that I think is good is that Johnny V stays with her, right? Like, I can't explain, you know, why, other than Johnny thinking that this horse is hot, that, you know, this is going to be a good horse. So I'm looking here at the three, long shot bet. I wouldn't do more than $2 across the board just for fun, but I see a lot of indicators that tell me you're going to have the three coming down on the stretch, passing horses, and you know, Johnny V knows how to ride them. He's going to be coming down and closing. So they're the picks for today. Sorry, I did a lot of reading off the past performances, but if I see anything else on the flight tomorrow, I'll light it up from the airport or something. But anyhow, again, the picks, race 2, number 3, race 5, we said the 2, and race 10, we said the 3. All right, nothing too crazy, but, you know, make your wages accordingly. And then I just want to recap that we're going to have a fun weekend this weekend. There's a lot of different things. I am thinking of a kind of conversation with some handicappers that I know. Great horses, great times, maybe some candid shots from the top of the stretch. If you're in Saratoga and you happen to see these videos and you want to come see us, we'll be up the top of the stretch at the picnic tables on the other side of the new entertainment boxes. So thank you, horse racing enthusiasts. Appreciate your time. Good luck at the track, and look for our videos. Like, subscribe, and please, any comments, shoot them out to us. Look forward to seeing you soon. Bye.